Synced blocks are a Notion block type that I use regularly in order to create navigation bars and also sync different content across pages. In this video, I wanted to do a quick guide on how to use synced blocks, use cases, and what to watch out for. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first go over how to add sync blocks. So to add a sync block, you can type /synced, you can click sync block, and then you're already going to have a sync block in here. What this does, let's say if I type here synced block, is that I can now copy and sync and then paste it in anywhere I want. And then when I add new information, it's going to sync across all of these blocks. So how this is useful is that let's say that I have another page here, and this one is another synced block test, and I can paste in this one here. So now if I go back to my original page, which has this sync block, then I can go ahead and type more things. And then if I go back to my sync block text here, it's going to also reflect that. So if I also type something in here, then if I go back, it's also going to sync there. So you can basically edit the information inside of a sync block anywhere you have that block, and it's going to update all of them at once. So that's very useful, especially if you have information that you need to keep consistent across different pages. The other thing to note is that when you have a sync block, you can click here to see everywhere that the sync block exists. So this way you can keep track of all of them. You'll know that this one is the original, and then you'll see that this one exists in this page. And then you can see that this is in another page here. And if you want to unsync the block, you can click this three dots here and then click unsync all, and then you'll be able to unsync them. So they're all going to be unsynced, puts it back to the block state. So what that does is here you see this block here again. And another thing to note if you're using sync block is that you can also transform a block of text like this to a sync block by clicking the six dots here. And then you can click turn into and then choose sync block. And this one is going to become a synced block. Not just text, you can also add things like buttons, all kinds of things that's available on a regular Notion page. You can basically add everything here. The first and most simplest use case that I wanted to go over is to use sync blocks to display really important information that you'd like to be consistent across different pages. So let's say you have something like a company homepage and you want to add a mission and values here. So you could do /synced block, and then inside here we could add a heading, let's say 1, mission and values, add your content here for mission and values. Then let's say that you also have a page here, which is for your marketing team. You want to also have your company-wide mission and values also in different areas of the department. Then what you can do is that you could go here and you could simply copy this one. And then if we go back to marketing, we can synced block like this. So now we can see the same mission and values as the one in the company homepage inside of the marketing page. So that's one way. Also, you can do things like company-wide events. This one could always be updated with the latest events, and that way you can see them also here in the company home, and you don't necessarily have to go to each different department to change each of them, but everyone will be notified about the company-wide events. The next use case that I wanted to share with you all is to use sync block as a way to capture your to-do list in a really quick way, especially for casual to-dos, similar to how you might use a sticky note. For this, I would recommend something like using a database. So I'm just going to create one inline new empty database. And let's say that you just have a daily planner and every day you plan your day out using this daily planner. And one way I can see the sync block be very useful in this case is to use the database template. So you can do +new template here. And in this new template, let's say that this is your new daily plan. And in here, we'll have a synced block where you can have a to-do list. So to-do list, and then you could have checkboxes in here like this. This is going to be synced across all of your pages. And then let's say you have more things here. Today's plans. Now what we can do is copy the link to this block, and then if we click out, then we can paste it in here, sync block, and we have our to-do list. So every day when you open a new daily plan and then you have your daily plan here, let's say that you want to make sure to pick up groceries. You can work from here, but you'll also see it in the main dashboard here as well. And this applies no matter how many daily plans you create. The next day, you could have another daily plan and you can add more things. If you want to have a centralized to-do list, that's not necessarily a database, something very quick, like a checklist, then this could be a really good way to keep track of them using this kind of database template setup. So the next way that I personally use sync blocks very often is as a navigation system. So to add a sync block for this use case, we're going to go ahead and type /synced block. And in here, there's going to be a navigation. So I'm going to go ahead and type navigation. You can style the navigation however you'd like. But the main thing is going to be that we're going to be adding pages inside. So let's say that we have this portfolio website and you want to have an about me page. So I'm going to go ahead and add an about me, and we can go ahead and add an icon here. Then let's say that you want to add some more pages, then you can go ahead and add another page. And this one could be services. We could add something like this. We have two pages. So now how this works is that we can now copy this sync block, and we can copy and sync or use the six dots here. And we can go to about me and paste this navigation in. And then in the services, we can also go ahead and paste this in. So when you're in about me, you can go here. And when you're in services, you can go here. To get back home, what I like to do is now add a button. So we can go ahead and add that button, return home with a house. And when the button is clicked, what I'm going to do is open page. And then here we can select the page, form, or URL where this is going to go. So for that, we can go ahead and copy the link to this page. And then I'm going to just paste it in. It's going to be open in full page and done. So now what happens is I go to about me, I can return home. If I go to services, I can return home. And all of these are interconnected as well. So it's very easy to use. Finally, I wanted to mention a few things to watch out for if you're using sync blocks. And that is that if you use a sync block, just keep in mind that if someone has an ability to edit the sync block, then they're going to be able to change every single instance of that you have pasted. So be careful who you let to edit your sync blocks. The other thing is that if you want to sync databases, then I would recommend using linked view databases instead. So let's say that I have a database here. You want to do something similar as the sync block. I would highly advise against adding databases into sync block. Instead, I would recommend getting the link to this one, and then you can just paste it in and then choose linked view database. And it's basically showing a copy of this one. So let's say new entry, and it's going to be shown here. So databases already have the ability to sync across different pages, but if you want to sync things like buttons, text, pages, all of these things that are not databases, then sync blocks are the way to go. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.